If gravity sucks, what blows? Quick answer, something hypothetically could blow, something absolutely does blow, and something else does not blow. Let's get into it. I love getting your questions, and if you have a question about chemistry, science, and life, just put it right down there in the comments. This question comes from David, who says, if gravity sucks, what blows? Is it dark matter? Okay, well, let's have a look at this question in a couple of parts. First of all, let's look at this idea. Is it dark matter? Well, what is dark matter? The interesting thing about our universe, there's all the stuff that we can see, of course, stars, planets, things like that. There's also stuff that we can't see directly, but we can detect it because light is shining on it from behind. So obviously, if we have a bright light, maybe a torchlight, someone passes their hand in front of that torchlight, well, you can kind of detect the hand. You can see the shadow of the hand. But it turns out that about only 5% of the matter that we can detect in the universe is of what we call kind of normal matter, the stuff that we can somehow detect with light. And that leaves an awful lot of stuff left. In fact, about 27% of this matter is something called dark matter. And dark is, I think, kind of a bad name for it. I think it should just be called invisible matter. Because dust is dark. If we have a big cloud of black dust, or at least dark grey dust, then yeah, that will make things dark. That will make stars dark. But dark matter doesn't do that. Dark matter is literally invisible. So the next question is, if it's invisible, how do we know it's there? We know that dark matter must exist because even though we can't see it, we can see the effect that it has on the rest of the universe, on the stars that we can see and the galaxies that we can see. So for example, if we look at this sphere, we can see it is floating. Spheres don't normally float, so there must be something pushing it up. And even though that thing is invisible to our camera, we know it must be there because of the way that it's moving and the way that it's spinning. And if we know how heavy that globe is, if we know how big it is, we can start to make some simple calculations to work out how much energy and how much matter is being used to hold it up in the air like that. And that's how we know that dark matter must be there. Very simply, we can see a couple of things. We can see how quickly galaxies rotate. We can see what happens as they move past each other. We can see what happens as galaxies actually collide with each other. And then we can do some simulations. And we can say, okay, if we only have stars in these galaxies and these two galaxies collide, we can calculate with our computers how those stars should move. And they don't move like that. And the only way we can get our simulations to work is by adding in lots of extra matter that kind of floats around in an invisible cloud. Now, another potentially more useful way of detecting dark matter is by something called gravitational lensing. Anything that is made of matter, but most especially anything big, anything huge made of matter, something like a large star, or especially something like a galaxy, will actually distort space. So something that was a straight line becomes bent. In other words, a beam of light traveling towards this big star will find itself moving around the star because of the distortion of space caused by the gravity of its mass. And what that does is it changes how we see whatever is behind that massive object. There might be a single star behind here, but we will see an image of the star from over here and from over here at the same time. We might see the image kind of smeared out along maybe part of a circular path. And that gravitational lensing gives us a direct way to measure how much mass must be in that area of space. And that's one way that we can see that there must be way more mass around that big object than we can actually see. And importantly, it also helps us to map out where that mass must be. So we can see, for example, two galaxies colliding. We can see their stars behaving in one way, and gravitational lensing helps us to see the dark matter that is going with those galaxies. And the dark matter just moves in a completely different way. And gravitational lensing allows us to see that. So, what is dark matter? We don't know. It could be certain kinds of very compact, dense matter, which is too cool to give off any light, and yet so dense that it's very difficult to actually spot them. Things like brown dwarfs, for example. Huge planets that almost become stars but not quite, or maybe even black holes. But everything we know about how stars and planets form tells us that there aren't going to be enough of these brown dwarfs or black holes. So our best bet after that is some kind of stuff that's invisible. I mean, you know, astronomers call them weakly interacting massive particles, or WIMPs, but that's just a fancy-pantsy word for stuff. However, if something is doing the opposite of gravity, it's not dark matter. Dark matter is behaving like matter. It is pulling things towards it. So it is absolutely doing what other matter does, and that's how we know it's there. So in terms of what blows, it certainly is not dark matter. So what else could blow? Is there anything that's the opposite of gravity, for example? One thing which isn't the opposite of gravity, but certainly could hypothetically blow, is a thing called a white hole. So I think by now everybody has heard of black holes. They're what happens when an enormous star collapses in on itself and makes, let's say, a hole that is so deep, with gravity that is so strong, that light cannot escape from it. In fact, nothing can escape from it at all. But if you look at the mathematical equations of this, there are some rather peculiar possible cases where you could have the opposite of a black hole, a white hole. You could have a thing where matter is continuously streaming out of a white hole. Now, there are all kinds of hypotheses and scenarios about how that might happen, but in all of them, white holes are very kind of unusual, exotic things. They are certainly not as, quotes, commonplace as black holes. And they are very much an artifact of the mathematics. They are not something that we get to by making observations of the universe. So, yes, sure, white holes might exist, but we certainly haven't seen anything in our universe that makes us think they definitely do exist in our universe. So, what does blow? Well, the thing that absolutely does blow is dark energy. Now, dark energy is similar to dark matter in that we can't detect it. We also don't have any good theories about what it is or where it's come from, but we can see the effect that it's happening on the universe. And this effect is that dark energy, whatever it is making the universe expand faster and faster and faster. And that's not what happens in a normal explosion. As we all know, in a normal explosion, things start out moving apart very fast, and then they lose their energy and they move out more and more slowly. But with dark energy, our universe is flying apart faster and faster and faster. So why is it doing that? Dark energy. And that's really the only explanation that we have so far. It's not anti-gravity, or at least I've never heard anybody call it that, but it is something, some property of our universe that nobody can yet explain, which is making stuff fly apart. But here's the really freaky thing about dark energy. It makes up most of our universe. In fact, dark energy is well over 60% of our universe, and dark matter, well over 20% of our universe, and normal matter, this stuff, is only 5% of our universe. In fact, we, in terms of the whole universe, we are made of exotic matter, this kind of stuff. So, if gravity sucks things together, what blows things apart? The answer is dark energy. Well, I hope you enjoyed David's question. And remember, if you have a question of your own, just put it right in the comment section and maybe I'll make a video about yours. And while you're about it, if you hit the like button, I'll make more videos. And if you hit subscribe, you'll know when they come out. See you next time.